you who know about our communities,
para aquellos que ya conocen acerca de nuestras comunidades,
you know that movies are a very big part of our mind training.
Ya saben que las películas son una gran parte de nuestro entrenamiento de la mente.
In Zen Buddhism, they have something called open-eyed meditation.
En el budismo Zen, tienen algo que llaman meditación de ojos abiertos.
Where you stay fully aware of your thoughts as they move through.
Cuando estás completamente consciente de tus pensamientos conforme van llegando.
So movies are an excellent way to watch your mind.
Así que las películas son una manera excelente de observar tu mente.
Pay attention to your emotions.
Poner atención a tus emociones.
And movies can help you discover what your unconscious beliefs are.
Y las películas te pueden ayudar a ver cuáles son tus creencias inconscientes.
Because when you react emotionally to the movie,
porque cuando reaccionas emocionalmente ante la película,
it's the same as reacting to people in your life.
Es lo mismo que reaccionar en frente a las personas en tu vida.
It's the same dynamics.
Es la misma dinámica.
If you have issues with people, it's a projection from your mind.
Si tienes problemas con las personas, es una proyección de tu mente.
And if you have reactions to the movie, it's coming from a projection from your mind.
Y si tienes reacciones con la película, viene de la proyección de tu mente.
So we watch movies because they accelerate healing.
Entonces vemos películas porque aceleran la sanación.
And they're usually a regular part of our practice and curriculum.
Y son una parte regular de nuestra práctica.
At times we can watch probably as much as one or two movies a day. Three.
Algunas veces observamos hasta tres películas al día.
Yeah. So it's not like an occasional movie for entertainment.
Así que no es como ver una película ocasional para entretenimiento.
And we have the Movie Watcher's Guide to Enlightenment.
Y tenemos la guía para observar las películas para la iluminación.
And now an online version.
Y ahora tenemos la versión en línea.
And this is very much a part of our community practice of clearing the mind.
Y es una parte común de la práctica de la comunidad para aclarar la mente.
Maybe you want to share about, we have some opportunities for community living.
It's all together. We just really felt that there is such a invitation from spirit to really join in closer, and we really wanted to extend what is really going on right now within communities and all the opportunities.
Es una oportunidad del espíritu para platicarles qué es lo que sucede en las comunidades.
All the opportunities that we have for joining.
Todas las oportunidades que tenemos para unirnos.
And it feels like there's an open window right now.
Y parece ser que ahora hay una ventana abierta.
And spirit is inviting. There's an invitation to the whole.
Y el espíritu, esto es una invitación para el todo,
to join closer,
para unirse más de cerca,
and to really deepen and immerse in the mind training.
Sumergirse e ir más profundo en el entrenamiento mental.
In the mind training and just in this way of living.
En el entrenamiento mental, en esta manera de vivir.
And so we just wanted to talk about all these opportunities that are available right now.
Y queremos hablar acerca de todas las oportunidades que están disponibles ahora.
And what's coming up for the month of October.
Y qué es lo que viene para el mes de octubre.
We're not going too far because we are literally living in the moment. It's just like what's available right now.
No podemos decirles qué va a pasar mucho más adelante porque nosotros literalmente vivimos en el momento. Entonces les podemos decir lo que está sucediendo justo ahora.
Yeah, so for those who are ready, so first, of course, we're going to start with Mexico. Entonces, Mexico.
Para aquellos que ya están listos, vamos a empezar, por supuesto, que primero con México.
And you are looking at it.
Y ustedes están viéndolo.
Must we say more?
No hay más que decir.
Yeah, like we already said that this is a really, really beautiful tropical place.
Ya dijimos que este es un hermoso lugar tropical.
Where there is no other purpose but awakening. Really.
Donde no hay ningún otro propósito más que despertar.
And this is our newest place as well.
Y también este es nuestro lugar más nuevo.
This is like the baby.
Es como el bebé.
So it's still learning to walk on some level.
Que a cierto nivel apenas está aprendiendo a caminar.
And so we are putting a lot of heart into it and a lot of support, and it's asking for support and heart.
Estamos poniendo mucho corazón y mucho apoyo en él porque nos está pidiendo mucho corazón y apoyo.
It's like this place is like that symbol of that spark within that needs to be supported and nurtured.
Este lugar es como esa chispa en el corazón que necesita ser apoyada y nutrida.
So that it can grow.
Para que pueda crecer.
And take you all the way.
Y llevarte de regreso a casa. Todo el camino de regreso a casa.
Yes, and we are in the middle of a retreat.
Estamos en medio de un retiro.
And so there are opportunities, those who really feel it in their hearts, you can just stay.
Y hay oportunidades para aquellos que realmente lo sientan en su corazón, se pueden quedar.
You can just stay.
Se pueden quedar.
It's available.
Hay disponibilidad.
There is space.
Hay espacio.
Or if you need some more time, if you want to take it in and come back again, we have another retreat in February.
O si quieren pensarlo, pueden y profundizar en esto. Tenemos otro retiro en febrero.
Michael, do we have the dates on that?
No. Last Tuesday of February.
Okay. Yeah.
Probably toward the end of February.
A finales de febrero.
Yeah.
I think, who was it? I was with Anita and Patrice, and they were saying that they were sure that there was some kind of retreat down here in February, but they couldn't find it on the internet. So we took that as a cue.
Ellas tres dijeron que ellas estaban seguras que iba a haber un retiro aquí en febrero, pero que no lo hallaban en internet. Entonces vamos a tomar eso como una pista, como una señal.
After three people say we're going to the retreat, we thought we better put a retreat up there.
Porque tres personas dijeron vamos a ir a un retiro, entonces vale más que pongamos un retiro.
And Michael was sharing that we probably should have a retreat every, what is it, three or four months?
Yeah.
Every 3 months.
Y Michael estaba diciendo que probablemente sería bueno tener un retiro cada tres o cuatro meses.
Yeah. Now that everything is up and running very strong.
Así que todo ya está en su curso muy fuerte.
Yeah. And that's Mexico. And it doesn't matter where you are on your journey, if you're just in the beginning exploring what A Course in Miracles is, if you've been doing it for a while.
Y no importa en qué punto del camino estás, si recién acabas de empezar a conocer el curso o ya lo has hecho durante un tiempo.
If you're even not into A Course in Miracles necessary, but you just really feeling a call.
O incluso puede ser que ni siquiera estés en el camino del curso, pero que estás sintiendo ese llamado.
Like I said, it doesn't matter. This is all is answered here.
Como dije, esto no importa. Aquí todo se responde.
In the end, it is the same call and it is the same answer.
Al final, siempre es el mismo llamado y siempre es la misma respuesta.
And
Claudia was at our Mallorca devotional. Which one was it? Was it the 4 week or the 6 week?
Claudia estaba estuvo en Mallorca por 6 semanas.
So 6 weeks, that was the longest like retreat we've ever held. Claudia made it through, survived.
Well, not all
6 semanas.
Not all 6 semanas. Part of those.
Yeah. 6 semanas es lo más largo que hemos hecho un retiro y Claudia sobrevivió a él, pero dice Claudia, no, nada más estuve 2 semanas.
And some of you know Suzanne.
Y algunos de ustedes también conocen a Suzanne.
She is starting it's about a 3-month retreat.
Ella empezó con un retiro de 3 meses.
Up in Camas, Utah.
En Camas, Utah.
I think it starts on October 17th.
Yeah.
En octubre.
Yeah. It runs 17. Through January 11th, so almost 3 months.
Hasta enero 11, o sea, casi 3 meses.
And it's called Heart on Fire.
Y se llama Corazón en...
Heart Ablaze.
Heart Fire.
Heart Fire. Okay.
Fuego de corazón.
Yeah, and it's a first.
Y este es el,
a 3-month retreat.
Este es el primero, un retiro de 3 meses.
That's the first that I know of.
Es el primero que yo he escuchado así.
It's like those who do choose to come to that retreat, it really looks like a bold move. And we're all in support of it.
Yeah, you might have to retire to attend that retreat.
Quizás se tenga que jubilar para poder atender a este retiro.
There's no guarantee you'll come back either.
It's a leap of faith.
Es un salto de fe.
It's really a quantum jump.
Es un salto cuántico.
Yeah, that's not unusual for us because I took early retirement when I was in my late 20s. Under the instructions of Jesus.
Bajo la instrucción de Jesús.
Who said, "You're mine now."
Él me dijo, "Tu mente ahora."
So that
tú eres, tú eres ahora.
Yes, yes. So that was that. And then also, Nikita took early retirement.
Yeah, very early.
¿Tú también te jubilaste muy pronto?
Middle 20s.
So that's another one. And then we have this one that's in Hawaii.
Y también tenemos otro que está en Hawaii.
On the ocean.
En el océano.
It's also new.
También es nuevo.
It's almost like that's the newest now. Now.
Casi que es también como que el más nuevo ahora.
Because it kind of resurrected.
Porque de cierta manera resucitó.
It comes complete with flowing lava.
Viene del flujo de la lava.
Albert can tell us about that.
You can't drive it.
Yeah, at some point it will be completely enclosed by the lava, so you really have to retire there for a while because you don't know when you're going to leave the island.
En cierto momento quizás va a estar totalmente cubierto por la lava, así es que se van a tener que retirar antes porque no van a saber cuándo van a regresar.
It's kind of a symbol of having no control over the world.
Es como un símbolo de no tener control sobre el mundo.
Jesus says that in his section in the course Rules for Decision.
Jesús lo dice en el curso en la sección Reglas para tomar decisiones.
He says you have no control over the world you made.
Él dice, tú no tienes ningún control sobre el mundo que tú hiciste.
So it's really pointing to the fact that you have control over your state of mind.
Entonces nos está señalando el hecho de que lo que tienes control es de tu mente.
But no control over the world is a script.
Pero ningún control sobre el mundo, sobre el
You have to just be very firm in your determination.
Tienes que ser muy firme en tu determinación.
To enjoy the ride.
Para disfrutar el viaje.
Regardless of what the ride looks like.
Sin importar cómo se ve el viaje.
Some of us have been practiced with amusement parks.
Algunos de nosotros hemos practicado en parques de diversiones.
And roller coaster rides.
En montañas rusas.
And life can be like that too.
Y la vida puede ser como eso yeah. también.
So Hawaii is the newest.
Entonces Hawaii es el más nuevo.
Yeah, and you'll be joining Lila in Hawaii. Suzanne in Camas, Lila in Hawaii.
Nikita in Mexico. Also, I had a call this morning from my friend Lisa. And Lisa is in Sedona.
Lisa está en Sedona.
And there's a group perhaps a house forming in Sedona, Arizona.
Entonces quizás se forme una casa en Sedona, California.
I'll know more tomorrow morning when I talk to her on the phone.
Mañana lo sabré, la mañana cuando hablé con ella.
And some of you know Sedona is famous for its energy vortexes.
Algunos de ustedes saben que Sedona es famoso por sus vórtices de energía.
But there's nothing more powerful than the I Am presence.
Pero no hay nada más poderoso que la presencia yo soy.
And so really everything is coming into that vortex.
Y en realidad todo está llegando a ese vórtice.
But it's just, it's very helpful to have reflections that remind you of the truth.
Pero es de mucha ayuda tener un reflejo que te recuerde la verdad.
And it's very supportive in the sense of helping you have the strength to choose the strength inside of yourself.
Y es de mucha ayuda que te ayude a escoger la fuerza que está en tu interior.
So, tonight's movie.
Entonces, la película de esta noche.
It's called Thanks for Sharing.
Se llama Gracias por Compartir.
Patrice.
It's like the fifth time, sixth time, which I love this movie.
Yes, I just showed this movie in Iowa.
Vimos esta película en Iowa.
And came here, and both Nikita and Kirsten were feeling, oh, thanks for sharing.
It's the this movie is the how.
Esta película es el cómo.
It's the answer to how.
Es la respuesta al cómo.
It's very practical.
Es muy práctica.
It's because, you know, we've talked about metaphysics and the awakening, and then now, so what does it look like? What does it mean to join? What does it mean to use everything for the awakening?
Hemos hablado de metafísica y de, pero ahora vamos a ver qué es lo que significa despertar, qué es lo que significa unirse.
So this movie shows that's what it means.
Esta película nos muestra lo que eso significa.
So, yeah.
I guess it shows too that you can't really do this alone.
Nos muestra que en realidad tú no puedes hacer esto solo.
It shows that we're all in this together.
Nos muestra que todos estamos en esto juntos.
And this movie explores the theme of addiction.
Y esta película explora el tema de la adicción.
And addiction is usually being associated with being out of control.
Y la adicción, por lo general, se conoce como que es algo que está fuera de control.
Being driven by unconscious impulses.
Como que es algo que es manejado por impulsos inconscientes.
Feeling a sense of vulnerability.
Es un sentimiento de vulnerabilidad.
Afraid of being consumed by chaos.
Miedo de ser consumido por el caos.
And I did ask Jesus, what is an addiction?
Y le preguntamos a Jesús, ¿qué es una adicción?
And Jesus said, the only addiction is judgment.
Y él dijo, la única adicción es el juicio.
Recently, in a movie called What the Bleep Do We Know?
Recientemente, en una película que se llama ¿Qué Sabemos?
There was a speaker, a teacher named Joe Dispenza. And he defined addiction as something that you cannot stop. So in a way, this fits very much with Jesus' definition. Because judgment is something that you cannot stop. You will exhaust yourself trying.
Te vas a quedar exhausto tratando de hacerlo.
But the reason that you cannot stop it,
pero la razón por la que no lo puedes detener,
is because in truth you never started it.
Es porque en la verdad tú nunca lo empezaste.
You have to start something before you stop it.
Y tienes que empezar algo antes de detenerlo.
And the teachings of the Course are that you have never, ever been able to judge.
Y las enseñanzas del curso son de que nunca, nunca puedes haber sido capaz de juzgar.
Because your Creator did not create you to judge.
Porque tu Creador no te creó para juzgar.
It's just a pretense.
Es una pretensión.
And with this pretense comes all guilt.
Y con esta pretensión llega la toda la culpa.
So when Jesus said in the Bible, "Judge not."
Cuando Jesús dijo en la Biblia, "No juzgues."
He was really pointing to a state of pure innocence.
Él realmente estaba señalando hacia un estado de inocencia pura.
In which judgment is impossible.
En el cual el juicio es imposible.
And saying, this is our natural reality.
Y decir, esta es nuestra naturaleza real.
As the living Christ.
Como el Cristo viviente.
Because Christ does not judge.
Porque Cristo no juzga.
Even with the woman who was caught in the act of adultery.
Aún a la mujer que fue atrapada en el acto de adulterio.
First Jesus said, he who is without sin, let him cast the first stone.
Primero dijo, aquellos que sean, que no tengan pecado, que arrojen la primera piedra.
And then, after all of the men dropped their stones,
y después de que todos los hombres soltaron sus piedras,
and they all walked away,
y todos se retiraron,
then the woman said to Jesus,
después la mujer le dijo a Jesús,
and what do you have to say to me?
¿Y tú qué tienes que decirme?
And he said, I condemn you not.
Y él le dijo, yo no te condeno.
The Christ is incapable of condemning.
El Cristo es incapaz de condenar.
And that was a beautiful demonstration of non-judgment.
Y esa fue una hermosa demostración de no juicio.
Acceptance of perfect innocence.
La aceptación de la perfecta inocencia.
So this movie tonight will give you the same opportunity.
Entonces la película de esta noche les va a dar la misma oportunidad.
Behind all the behaviors,
detrás de todos los comportamientos,
and all of the emotions,
y todas las emociones,
there is a stillness,
hay una quietud,
and a happiness and joy,
y una felicidad y gozo.
But you have to go through the forgiveness process,
pero tienes que ir pasar a través del proceso de perdón.
And ultimately, this is a movie about forgiveness.
Y en realidad, toda esta película es acerca del perdón.
It shows forgiveness in action.
Yeah, it shows just really what it looks like. It's not like forgiveness is not passive.
No, es como que el perdón es pasivo.
And it really, because we talk a lot about joining. What does it mean to join?
Porque hablamos acerca de unirnos. ¿Qué significa unir?
And so the main characters, they join in this one purpose and no other purpose.
Y los personajes principales se unen en este propósito y en ningún otro más.
Which is forgiveness.
¿Cuál es el perdón?
And to really face that addiction and go to the light together.
Para enfrentar la adicción e ir a la luz juntos.
And the joining is so strong, everything naturally comes to the surface very quickly.
Y porque la unión es tan fuerte, todo sale a la superficie muy rápidamente.
Like everything that doesn't belong to the light,
como que todo lo que no pertenece a la luz,
gets exposed really fast.
Se expone muy rápidamente.
And this is like it, and it's really, and there's no judgment really.
Y en realidad no hay juicio.
There is no judgment, there is no pointing out the error
no
in the brother.
Juicio, no hay señalar el error al hermano.
There's really one purpose, to know the truth.
Solo hay dos propósitos, conocer la verdad.
And to remind each other of the truth.
Y recordarse uno a otro la verdad.
Knowing that seeing the truth in your brother is seeing it within, is claiming it for yourself.
Sabiendo que ver la verdad en tu hermano es ver la verdad en ti.
And yeah, and they are yeah, they're great. It is truly, it's just like I keep hearing non-judgment. This is the ultimate non-judgment. It's just really joining.
No juicio, no juicio.
Like it's almost like when I watched it, I almost felt like it's impossible to judge.
Cuando yo la vi, fue como que surgió como que es imposible juzgar.
Although the form seems to be playing out in a very intense way,
aunque la forma parece ser que está sucediendo de una manera muy intensa,
but it's like you can't even, it's easy to go beyond it because the purpose is so strong.
Pero es muy fácil ir más allá de ella porque el propósito es muy fuerte.
You can feel the true desire, the true prayer of the heart.
Puedes sentir el verdadero deseo, la verdadera oración del corazón.
And you can feel it and see it in the movie that that's the only thing that has true power. The rest has no power at all and shall pass.
Y puedes ver que eso es lo único que tiene verdadero poder. Todo lo demás no tiene poder y pasará.
Yeah.
How many of you are familiar with the 12-step program?
¿Cuántos de ustedes están familiarizados con el programa de 12 pasos?
It's a very helpful program for overcoming addictions of all sorts.
Un programa muy famoso para sobrellevar las adicciones.
In this program, the 12 steps focus on sex addiction.
En este programa se enfoca en 6 adicciones.
Yeah. Very much of a lesser known aspect of the program.
Six.
Anybody here addicted to six? That's why the sign of the devil is 666. I think we have six additions.
Addictions.
But in this program, Alcoholics Anonymous,
pero en este programa de los Alcohólicos Anónimos,
is referred to as the drink program.
Se refiere como al programa de beber.
Yeah. But we will see that even in sexuality, this could still be taken over by the ego.
Pero vamos a ver que incluso en la sexualidad también se entra el ego.
And the healing occurs regardless of what the addiction seems to be.
Y la sanación ocurre sin importar cuál sea la adicción.
And in the 12-step program, sometimes there are beginners.
Y en el programa de 12 pasos, algunas veces hay principiantes.
Who are brand new. They come to the program brand new.
Que son nuevos, que llegan al programa.
And then there are those that have been part of the program for years.
Y después están aquellos que dependen del programa por años.
And then there are sponsors who have been in the program for many years
que han estado en el programa por muchos años
and are like mentors or role models.
Son como los modelos, los mentores.
We see in this movie that the Holy Spirit sees all of them as the same.
Y vamos a ver en esta película que el Espíritu Santo lo ve a todos iguales.
The Holy Spirit uses everyone.
El Espíritu Santo utiliza a todos.
So there's no beginners and intermediate and advanced.
Así que no hay principiantes, intermedios ni avanzados.
They all need each other and they all need help.
Todos se necesitan unos a otros y todos necesitan ayuda.
And it's the same with all of us.
Y es lo mismo con todos nosotros.
Nobody is ahead, nobody is behind.
Nadie está adelante, nadie va detrás.
That's just the trick of the ego.
Ese es un truco del ego.
There's really only one of us.
En realidad solo hay uno de nosotros.
And when we experience that, we experience peace of mind.
Y cuando experimentamos eso, experimentamos paz mental.
Yeah.
Okay. We close to roll them?
Yeah, and it's also accepting what's given. You know, that program, it's like they all have this deep, 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 true desire for healing, true healing. And what's given is the context of the 12-step program.
En este programa también está ese profundo, profundo deseo de sanar. Y todo eso está incluido en el programa de 12 pasos.
Yeah, and it's totally, and all of it, it's like, you have, like, they embrace it fully.
Y todo lo abrazas completamente.
Because this is what's given, and then, so that the healing, and they accept their place. Beginners, middle, veterans.
Porque eso es lo que es dado. Y cada uno toma su lugar como principiante, intermedio, avanzado.
And so that spirit can show them that really all the same, there is no hierarchy.
Pero después vemos que todos son lo mismo, que no existe jerarquía.
And it's very, very clear in that movie. It's very clear.
Y en esta película todo eso es muy, muy claro.
So, yeah.
Okay.
Okay, how does everyone like it? Very raw living. It's really good in this movie seeing the fear of loss of control. Seemingly acting out with the addictions when there's a sense of losing control in the mind. And different people use different ways of doing it, but there's a deep fear that's underneath. And again, it's what we talked about earlier today. It's a fear of divine love.
Es el temor o el miedo al amor divino.
Which is the ego's fear of loss of self. So this kind of movie shows how important miracle working is. Because binging or trying to control the behavior doesn't work.
Porque comer de más o tratar de controlar la conducta no funciona.
It takes miracles to discipline the mind.
Necesitan milagros para poder disciplinar la mente.
And open up to divine love.
Y abrirse al amor divino.
So it's a pretty direct movie.
Meditation.
Meditation
doesn't work. Meditation doesn't even work. Yeah, it's like when you come upon this fear. The addiction is fear.
La adicción es el miedo.
This is where almost all the tools fall away. This is where meditation is not going to get you out of it.
Aquí donde la meditación te va a sacar de esto.
You can't just meditate it away.
No puedes nada más meditarlo hasta que te haga.
This is truly surrender. The only thing you can do is just surrender.
Realmente lo único que se puede hacer en este momento es rendirse.
And truly just accept what's given. Embrace it.
Y realmente lo que verdaderamente hay que hacer es rendirse y elevar lo que sea que surja.
Yeah, like Neil, the fat guy, like you could see how he was denying it, as if, I don't have a problem, no, resisting. And yet he ended up in that program. And that, therefore, it was an obvious sign that he needs, there's a lot of help needed. And so, eventually, he really had to recognize it and surrender to it fully. Like Adam said, I need 150% from you.
Y eventualmente tuvo que reconocerlo y entregarse de lleno, como le dijo Adam, que necesitaba el 150% de su entrega.
Like I need a yes on everything.
Y necesito que digas que sí a todo.
Yeah, it's like, it's dedication. commitments.
También se trata de la dedicación y del compromiso.
And complete, this is also where it's just complete non-judgment. Is required.
Esto se necesita, es un requisito.
And complete openness.
Una apertura completa.
This is where you make no decisions on your own and you make no conclusions.
Y aquí es donde tú no tomas decisiones por tu cuenta y tampoco llegas a conclusión alguna.
And here you don't, you really can't judge your advances from your retreats.
Y aquí no puedes emitir juicios sobre tus avances o tus retrocesos.
Like I feel like this movie shows it very, like very clearly. It's like this isn't an ordinary path. This is completely, this is new. Yeah.
The sponsor was played by Timothy Robbins.
Y el que es el mentor o el patrocinador que lo representa el actor Timothy Robbins.
And he had been in the Alcoholics Anonymous 12-step and the Sex Addicts.
Y él estaba también en el programa de 12 pasos de Alcohólicos Anónimos y en el de Adictos al Sexo.
And yet he had a very disagreement with his son.
Y aún así él tenía un agravio muy grande hacia su hijo.
So really, the addiction is this feeling of unworthiness.
Realmente la adicción es este sentimiento de no merecer, de no merecimiento.
And unworthiness comes from judgment and guilt.
Y esta sensación de no merecimiento proviene de los juicios y de la culpa.
So until this unworthiness is completely exposed and released.
Y hasta que esta sensación de no merecimiento se expone por completo y se libera.
The ego will just project it onto another form or another situation.
El ego lo va a seguir proyectando hacia otra forma o hacia otra situación.
And this is why healing and forgiveness has to become the priority in your life.
Y es por esto que la sanación y el perdón debe convertirse en una prioridad en tu vida.
Because no one is partially healed.
Porque no hay quien pueda estar parcialmente sanado.
Just like no one is partially pregnant. You can never accept atonement for yourself and for everyone without a discipline of the mind. And this is why it's good to really give your heart over to the Holy Spirit.
Y por eso es que es muy bueno entregarle tu corazón al Espíritu Santo.
Because the Holy Spirit needs all of you, or all of who you think you are.
Porque el Espíritu Santo necesita todo lo que tú eres o todo lo que tú crees que eres.
You can't hold on to some aspects of the ego.
No te puedes agarrar o continuar con algunos aspectos del ego.
It does take a total commitment.
Sí requiere un compromiso total.
But you are so worthy of this commitment.
Pero en verdad tú vales, tú eres completamente valioso y mereces este compromiso.
On our first night we talked about peace of mind being our shared goal.
Y en la primera noche hablamos y cómo compartimos que la paz de la mente es nuestra meta compartida.
And if you honestly and sincerely devote your life to peace of mind.
Y si sincera y honestamente dedicas tu vida a la paz de la mente.
It must be that you will experience it.
Quiere decir que la vas, tiene que ser que la vas a experimentar.
Because the mind is that powerful.
Porque así es de poderosa la mente.
What you focus on, you bring into awareness.
En lo que tú dedicas tu atención o lo que tú dedicas tu atención va a aparecer a tu conciencia.
So even though the human race is known for different achievements and milestones.
Entonces, aun cuando la raza humana sea conocida por conseguir algunas muchos logros y llegar a ciertas metas.
Like the billions of dollars it took to put a man on the moon.
Como la cantidad de millones de dólares que se necesitaron para poner al hombre en la luna.
Or to win Olympic gold medals by training for many, many hours at athletic endeavors.
O por ejemplo, me da medallas de oro después de muchísimas horas de dedicar a entrenamiento atlético.
Peace of mind is a more worthy goal for you.
Realmente la paz de la mente es una meta mucho más valiosa para ti.
Because it's a goal you can actually experience. It's not something that just shifts from one goal to the next. It's the last goal. And it's not even a future goal. It's just the goal of being fully present. So this movie is a great reminder.
Y esta película es un gran recordatorio.
It reminds us all again of what it is that we truly want.
Me recuerda nuevamente a todos de qué es lo que realmente queremos.
Yeah, I just see it, how it's just really underneath, like the addiction is intense. It's intense.
Realmente lo veo que es como que la adicción es como una danza.
The addiction to judgment, the addiction, like judgment, aka the world,
like,
aka this thought system. But what's even stronger is a call for love. It's much, much stronger. That's why, like, why do we have to, like, there is this question, there could be this question, well, if it's enlightenment, shouldn't it be happy? Shouldn't we just like talk about the truth and enlightenment and be happy and join in the truth, right? And meditate and then just feel good, you know? And we can. It is available. Technically, it's like even Jesus says, he doesn't say don't do that. Yes, it will get you to the truth. But the call of the heart, the most direct path, how do we get there in the most direct way? And it is through facing the addiction. But not stopping there, just like going further. And that's the real fear, like the fear of love. So it's, and it's, that's why you can't judge it. Really, because it may not feel good sometimes. And it may feel intense and like, you know, shame will come up. It's just like, it's not what you would call a feel-good experience. I was going with it somewhere. But, it may not feel good, yeah, but underneath that intensity, there's even more intense joy. And it may not, like, we may not even feel it all the time, like, when we're seemingly looking at it, like at the addiction. But it's just trusting that it's there, and it's actually, that's what's triggering the whole thing to come to the surface, because the joy is too intense. So it's just like, that's what really wants to reveal. That's what's really asking to be revealed, and so it's just like, that's why it's a lot of trust. It takes a lot of trust, and that's why commitment and not making any conclusions and not even.
Uh,
and not knowing what works, what doesn't, and letting go of good and bad. Yeah, but really, simply going with the call of the heart, just being really in touch with the call of the heart to know the truth and we don't want to waste time. Why delay? It's like the most direct way is given, and this is where the joy is. Like the joy is in like knowing that you're going for it. Yeah.
It's like once you see that judgment is the addiction.
Una vez que puedes ver que la adicción, el juicio es la adicción.
And addiction to a personal identity.
Y que es una adicción a una identidad personal.
At some point, you have to come clean.
En algún punto ya tienes que, ya salir limpio.
You have to tell your family and friends you need a rehabilitation. You have to check yourself into the Holy Spirit's Rehabilitation Center. And tell them you've had a major perceptual problem. Been addicted to time. And are finally going to come clean. And really, you're telling them for yourself. You have to come to an admission that you're not really good at managing time. You've had a bad case of poor time management. You've been trying to rearrange things in the world and make a better life. Still believing that there was some solution in form. Because everybody has the love already in their heart. It's just covered over by all these false pursuits. And all the pursuits are just to be right about identity.
Si todas estas metas o estos logros quieren tener la razón sobre tu identidad.
Like the sponsor's wife said, you always have to be right.
Como le dice la esposa del patrocinador o del mentor, siempre tienes que tener la razón.
Rather be right about a small identity than be happy for eternity.
Prefieres estar contento por una pequeña identidad y no por la eternidad, la felicidad de la eternidad.
It's amazing that that's what the decision is. To try to be so convinced that you're right about the world. And that God is wrong about you. And then playing this time game, waiting for God to change his mind. Waiting for God to say, oh, okay, all right. Go have your separate identity. Go play with fantasies as long as you want. Millennium. Just take millennium if you need it. I'll be waiting for you. I'll wait till you come back home. But God is not waiting.
Pero Dios no está esperando.
God is not a believer of time.
Dios no es alguien que crea en el tiempo.
God isn't even patient.
Dios ni siquiera tiene paciencia.
Because there's no time.
Porque no hay tiempo.
And God does not forgive.
Y Dios no perdona.
Because God has never condemned.
Porque Dios nunca ha condenado.
Forgiveness is for yourself.
El perdón es para ti.
It's to free your mind and open it back to eternity.
Es para liberar tu mente y abrirla para hacia la eternidad.
There's only one mind that needs forgiveness.
Hay una sola mente que necesita el perdón.
The mind that believes in illusions.
La mente que cree en las ilusiones.
All it has to do is let go.
Lo único que tiene que hacer es soltar.
And say, I was completely mistaken about everything.
Y decir, estaba completamente equivocada acerca de todo.
Absolutely everything.
Y absolutamente todo estaba equivocado.
And then you awaken from this dream.
Entonces puedes despertar de este sueño.
But not without a happy dream.
Pero no sin tener un sueño feliz.
That's why we are really all here.
Por eso es que estamos todos aquí realmente.
To allow ourselves to experience a happy dream.
Para permitirnos a nosotros mismos experimentar un sueño feliz.
To see we have never been good at judging.
Poder ver que nunca hemos sido buenos para emitir juicios.
But we can become very good at forgiving.
Pero podemos convertirnos en alguien muy bueno para perdonar.
So you will never figure this world out.
Y realmente nunca vas a encontrar explicaciones para este mundo.
It's a puzzle that cannot be solved.
Es un rompecabezas que no puede ser resuelto.
But you can forgive it.
Pero sí lo puedes perdonar.
And that's what we're joined in.
Y en eso estamos unidos.
We want to simply learn how to forgive.
Simplemente lo que queremos es aprender a perdonar.
As Jesus taught us how to forgive.
Como fue que Jesús nos enseñó a perdonar.
Effective forgiveness.
Un perdón efectivo.
Not forgiving somebody because we think they did something wrong to us.
No perdonar a alguien pensando que lo perdonamos porque hizo algo mal contra nosotros.
But just seeing our perception was very mistaken.
Sino solamente ver que nuestra percepción estaba completamente equivocada.
So really, that's all we can talk about is forgiveness.
Así que realmente lo único que podemos hablar es acerca del perdón.
And beyond that, there's really no use for words.
Y más allá de eso, en realidad no hay ningún uso para las palabras.
And no use for movies.
Y no tendrían sentido uso las películas.
Each movie just reminds us of one thing.
Y cada película solamente nos recuerda una sola cosa.
It's time for me to forgive.
Ya es hora para que yo perdone.
Sounds good.
So, are there any questions?
¿Hay pregunta?
Yeah, there's not a mic, so just project.
Yeah.
No hay micrófono, pero quieren hablar en voz alta.
Or come to the hot seat,
yeah.
Too.
Oh, and yeah, and then I can use this one.
Jeff goes,
yeah.
That's for sure, and I'm not going now. His arms folded at the word Hudson. There's a kind of hush all over the world tonight, over the world, in the sound of his delight. You know what I mean? That's it. Yeah, it starts to become so obvious. Your heart gets filled up and ready for the next altar session. Where you commit, I will hide nothing. I will not be embarrassed.
No voy a sentirme con vergüenza.
To let these emotions move through me.
De permitir que estas emociones se muevan a través de mí.
No matter what they are.
Sin importar de qué se trate.
I am safe.
Estoy segura.
And this is the way to healing.
Y este es el camino para sanar.
About feelings coming up watching movies, I noticed that when the sun had been falsely accused by the father stealing the pills. And,
hablando de sentimientos que surgen en las películas, me di cuenta con la escena en la que el joven está molesto con su papá porque lo escuchó de robar las pastillas.
There was a part of me that was just saying to the son, yeah, hit him.
Hay una parte de mí que le estaba diciendo al hijo, sí, golpéalo, golpéalo.
And then he hit him. I'm like, yeah.
Y lo golpeó.
And then now I feel guilty and
y ahora me siento culpable por esto.
Unevolved and
y como sin evolucionar.
Yeah, like that was wrong, but it felt good.
Como que eso estaba mal hecho, pero se sintió bien.
Is there hope for me?
There, the smile is the yes.
You know the answer. Oh, come on, you tell us. What has been your experience? Would there be a hope for someone like you in such a place? You've been here for a while.
Yeah, but I still feel guilty when I have that. Oh,
yeah.
That's why this is the rehab center.
Yeah.
One flew over the cuckoo's nest.
I've been in all those programs, by the way.
Yeah, I graduated from this one.
Yeah.
He landed here.
Yes,
that's good. Yeah. He landed in this rehab program.
That's why the invitation to hide nothing, like dare to hide nothing, let it come up.
Por eso la invitación a no esconder nada, atreverse a dejar que todo salga.
Yeah, even if it's a simple, yeah, hit him.
Sí, así sea un simple, sí, golpéalo.
Yeah, like everything. So it's just that kind of permission, yeah. And not judge, not make any conclusions.
Es ese permiso y que no te juzgues y que no llegues a ninguna conclusión.
Do you ever feel guilty? Do you ever feel it and just have to like look at it, or do you never feel it anymore?
No, I see no reason for it.
Anymore.
I have no experience.
So not even little small things like, ooh, that orange juice is bigger and I want the big one, not the small one. I'm going to take the big one.
No, I'm not looking to get anything from the world. That never worked. So even more orange juice is not. No more OJ. But what you give, if you give and you're just in the experience of giving, then you don't experience any lack. But you have to dedicate your whole life to giving. And it's actually wonderful, there's no cost. There's no downside to giving. Yeah. Because what we're giving really is the miracle. And there is no limit to the miracle. Because it comes from our source. So you become habitually a giver. And then the desire to get just goes smaller and smaller, and then it disappears. You don't even have to get respect from the world. Remember that song? R-E-S-P-E-C-T. Find out what it means to me. It's in your heart. It doesn't, you don't get it from the world.
Imagine that. You don't even need respect from people. When you're a giver. Because you receive everything that you give. Because it's one mind. So it takes away any chance of guilt.
And similarly, do you ever think, hit them or never? I never
see that in the movie. I never think of that.
That's why it's the path of, long story short about this path, it's love or a call for love.
And
the response for either one is love. And at some point Jesus tells you, you don't even know how to discern. You don't even know what a call for love is. Therefore you don't even know what forgiveness is. And so that's an invitation to just open up your mind and say, okay, teach me. And then everything is given, all kinds of tools and the means are given, the specific means. To learn to answer with love, to love and to a call for love. And
so, until
there's no more discerning and then there's just love and you don't... As long as there's guilt, you're going to see a call for love, but attack is not the answer. Forgiveness is, and so, and then somehow graduated. Yeah, and others are learning still, and it's an honor. If there's any learning to be left in the mind, forgiveness would be the one last lesson to be learned.
Everything used that scene that Annie mentioned, just look at it a little deeper.
Yeah.
The scene in the movie where the sponsor and the son, the sponsor is, the sponsor seems to be hypocritical. Because he's not... He's not transferring the 12 steps to his son. Yeah. But when there is a judgment or an interpretation of some person being hypocritical, which is where the anger arises, which is where the hidim arises, it is projecting the error of the ego to time. Because the ego is hypocritical. It's the belief that you can separate from God, but you can't. And so you're believing something that actually is impossible. And really not being honest about your identity. And then it seems convenient to see it acted out in the world. And to project the anger out onto other characters. When you project it to the character that you call yourself, it comes out as sickness. sickness is anger taken out upon the body. That's where symptoms come in. And when you project it out onto other characters, it is justified with some kind of story or interpretation. But it is never seen to be a belief in the mind. But if God created you perfect, as spirit, and you have denied this, and identified with another option, a human option, that is hypocritical. And there's an anger in the mind. The anger of believing you are something that you are not. And so, really, the mind needs forgiveness in a very deep way. What would be honest? Say, I am a child of God. I am as God created me. I am innocent. I am love. Those would all be accurate statements. But the ego is not accurate. And if you identify with the ego, you will feel its emotions. And the ego is a death wish. And you would expect a death wish to feel angry. Or guilty. But not a child of God. So fear is an unnatural emotion. And the Bible says, perfect love casts out fear. If that was the only sentence in the Bible, that would be very accurate. So that's why we check into the rehab center. And you can really appreciate when people let their emotions up. I have had very good role models in my life. My cat is very expressive with her emotions. She does not hide her emotions. Even Iso is a different breed. Nikita said, oh, Iso is different.
Yeah.
But Tripod has a very loud meow. And when she's upset, you know it. You don't have to guess. But I see that as a valuable thing. That's why we encourage you to express your emotions. And say whatever's on your mind. And then when your mind is clear, you'll have a lot of love to share. Because the shadow emotions, they just disappear. They were never natural. It's really simple. But the practice can be intense. Okay, well, I think we had a beautiful night tonight.
Okay.
Very healing.
Yeah.
Thank you for coming. So go to your groups tomorrow morning.
Yeah.
In the rehab center.
Take advantage of your rehab center. Of this rehab center, your groups, of the whole thing. Yeah.